ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन एनिमल, स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन एनिमल यूनिट टू इट इज दैट विद स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन एनिमल्स वी हैव अ टैग लाइन हियर द टिश्यूज के अगेन लर्न मेजरली अबाउट द टिश्यूज So the tissues considered as jocks of all trades and masters of none. Tissues are considered as jocks of all trades and masters of none. So why they did consider like that? We need to check how to enter into the chapter structural organization in animal. Before we enter into the chapter, let me remind you that the brief introduction of the. Scientist Bichet is given here. Bichet was a French anatomist and physiologist, the best remembered as the father of modern histology and pathology. He coined the term tissue. That Bichet is a scientist who coined the term tissue. Coined the term tissue. Okay. So then, best remembered as the father of modern histology and pathology. He is remembered as father of modern histology and pathology. He coined the term tissue. That you need to remember. He coined the term tissue. He is the father of modern histology, and he revealed the diseases attack tissues rather than whole organ. That means the tissue level, how the particular microbes are going to be attacked over. He explained. So that's why. Before we enter into the histology, before we enter into the tissues, it's better to remember the scientist Bichet. Okay, then let's start. Let's start the chapter, the structural organization in animals. Structural organization in animals. So we have a brief introduction here. We'll go with the introduction in the evolution of animals. The major event of significance is the development of tissue. Development of tissues is the major event of significance. Development of the tissues is the bigger step in the evolution. The tissue grade of organization evolved for the first time in the cnidarians. That means we learned kingdom Animalia in detail. So which is going to be much helpful for us to learn all these particular things. That if you remember, I explained tissue grade of organization is seen in kingdom Animalia, subkingdom Eumetazoa, and grade Radiata. In grade Radiata or Diploblastica, which include phylum Cnidaria and Deinophora, are with the tissue grade of organization. First time it was there in phylum Cnidaria. Okay, so then when the zygote undergoes cleavage, it results in the production of many cells. During the embryogenesis itself, the cells differentiate themselves into different kinds of tissues to perform the different function. What do you say it as? Division of labor. Division of labor. So that means zygote is dividing 2 cell, 4 cell, 8 cell, 16, 32. Likewise, when it is dividing, so it is going to divide. The various kinds of tissues are developed in the process of development of embryo, and the tissues will fix to their certain functions. So that what do you say that as division of labor? When a cell is marked for a specific function, both the cell and its descendants are destined to do that specific function only. This is actually exception in the sponges here, because sponges is having the cellular grade of organization is present in the sponges, where the cells are having individual performances there. But we are talking from Cnidaria onwards, the total animal kingdom, Cnidaria to Chordata, human being including all of them. When a tissue is fixed for a function, every cell of that particular tissue is going to be directed toward that function only. Okay, that in the parajuvan, who is parajuvan? So that's what I'm saying here. learning kingdom animalia is beneficial for us to understand the whole chapter. So I do remember you once you have to watch all the videos of kingdom animalia. We said kingdom animalia classified into subkingdom parazoa and subkingdom eumetazoa. Subkingdom parazoa and subkingdom eumetazoa. Kingdom animalia is also called metazoa. Okay, do remember that. And now let's talk about this area. In the parazoans, mature cells can de-differentiate or re-differentiate and perform certain functions that are not their usual functions. For example, that means who is parazoan? Parazoan means that phylum Porifera, which include sponges. So we are talking about sponges. In the parazoans, that means in sponges of phylum Porifera, mature cells can de-differentiate or re-differentiate and perform certain functions that are not their usual functions. That example is given here. For example, a coenocyte of a sponge, which can stop its normal function of collection of food, and digestion, and can produce the gametes. Coenocytes are the special cells which are present in the sponges. So what they are saying, these coenocytes can perform that. In general, they have their own function, that intracellular digestion, collection of the food. But they, at the time of reproduction, they can also produce the gametes. We are talking about the sperms. They are going to produce the sperms. So likewise, that example is given. So many other examples are there. Totipotent cells, we say that in case of sponges, so that can form any type of cell of the body. That totipotent cell of sponges can form any type of cell. We're going to learn all the details in animal kingdom chapter. So just example wise, that information given here. In the parazoans, a mature cell can de-differentiate or re-differentiate and perform certain functions that are not their usual function. For example, a coenocyte of a sponge can stop its normal function of collection of food and digestion, can produce the gametes. It can produce the gametes. Their normal function is food and digestion, but if the time comes when it going to produce the gametes, particularly sperms, you have to talk about. And production of tissues has an evolution. Do remember, this is just introduction here. We're going to learn everything in detail in the chapter. Then some details we'll have in animal diversity one chapter. Production of tissues has an evolutionary advantage compared to organisms in which there are no true tissues. That we have example sponges, that phylum Porifera of subkingdom Parazoa of kingdom Animalia. They don't have tissues. Only cellular grade of organization is present in them. As somebody rightly observed, tissues are jocks of all traits and masters of none. Why we say like that? They do take part in every biological activity, doing their assigned function, contributing their part of the completion of the overall integrated biological activity of the organism. The tissues are essentially four types: epithelial, connective, muscular, nervous. Let's take one example to understand this particular concept. Tissues are jocks of all trades and masters of none. That means in the stomach, in the kidney, that wherever you go, in the stomach, in the kidney, then in heart, that we have the cardiac musculature tissue in the stomach. Various tissues are present, mucosal tissue and muscular tissue, smooth muscles are present. That means that every organ is made up of different kinds of tissues here. And the tissues are performing different kinds of functions. But what we are going to say, they are not the masters of that particular organ. We are going to say that they take part and they use role in them. But we can't say that he is a master of that particular organ or that particular system or the particular organism. Okay, so that's why we are going to say simply that in our human being, we are taking human being itself as an example. that the whole body is made up of epithelial, connective, muscular and nervous tissue. The whole body. That means in the end of this chapter, you people are going to be able to say that every part that made up of what type of tissue, that you will be able to say, like that skin is made up of stratified, squamous, keratinized epithelium, like the kidney is made up of nephrons. The kidney is made up of nephrons. So the heart is made up of cardiac muscle. Likewise, every part. So that means every organ, every system of our body is with various types of tissues and performing various functions. What do you say? Jocks of all trades, but masters of none. Okay, let's continue. So we said now, there are four types of tissues, epithelial, connective, muscular and nervous. The four types of tissues are present here, epithelial and connective, muscular and nervous. Epithelial tissues, we have the detailed explanation of each and every tissue here in the coming chapter. So just we are going a brief information. Epithelial tissues cover the outer surfaces or free surfaces of the body organ and act as physical barriers, protecting organism from pathogens. They are also involved in the repair of injuries. The epithelia in sense organs receive sensory stimuli. Epithelia in sense organs receive sensory stimuli. They form glands which are secretory in function in certain regions of the body. So these tissues show several adaptations to meet the requirements of the body. Then connective tissues help in binding and supporting of other tissues. A connective tissue has diffuse cells interspersed by extracellular matrix made by the different types of fibers like collagen, elastic and reticular fiber. Just a formality here, we are going to learn the complete information of the connective tissue. Just this is an introduction paragraph introducing that each and every tissue here, that various types of connective tissues we are going to learn. Then let's see here. Various types of fibers are formed by the cells called fibroblast cells. The matrix of connective tissue also contains macrophages which phagocytize pathogens, which are going to phagocytize pathogens. Then let's take muscular tissue, the third type of tissue. The muscular tissues are concerned with various types of the movements in the body. They contain proteins such as actin and myosin, which together cause contraction in a muscle. The muscles are of three types in general: skeletal, cardiac, and smooth. The skeletal and cardiac muscles are of the striated type, and the smooth muscles are all called unstriated type, and they are also called visceral muscles. Finally, the nervous tissue. The nervous tissue senses stimuli and transmits what you say, that them in the form of nerve impulses, action potentials, we use it to say, from one part of the body to the another. It consists of nerve cells called neurons. The nervous tissue also contains various types of glial cells that which help in nourishment, insulation of axons, protection, likewise. Nervous tissue is chiefly involved in bringing about coordination between the activities of the various body parts. We call it as neural integration. Okay. You probably understand now why somebody called tissues of the jocks of all trades and masters of none. So simply we can say like this, they are present everywhere in the body, but they are doing all the functions, but they cannot be a master of any organ or any system, any tissue. That we are talking about the tissues. Is there any organ or a system of an organism? They can't be a master, we are saying. So finally, that this is just introduction. Here we have introduction about the four types of tissues like epithelial, connective, the muscular and nervous. The coming chapter, that in the continuation, going to learn the detailed explanation of these four tissues: epithelial, connective, muscular, nervous. Okay, let's continue. Some more introduction is there. So we have to start with the levels of organization.